I got into somebody else's car at ShopRite the other day and nothing happened.
Oh my God, I hate that. Oh, hello.
Hi.
We're back.
Hello. Oh,
it's the 15-Minute Morning Show podcast.
It's a brand new day.
Here's Garrett and then Dave Brody and Straight Nate and Scotty B.
Hi.
And Scary. There's Danielle and Gandhi and Froggy. Hi, guys.
Hello.
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 So what sort of X-rated mischief are we getting into today? Oh.
That's a great question.
As soon as Scotty opens his mouth, we'll know.
I'm eating blueberries. Leave me alone.
You love blueberries.
I do.
I have a question.
What's that, Brody?
So I was out to eat this weekend with a friend, and we watched a guy with a Jeep pull into the parking lot outside the restaurant. And he had the roof off and the doors off, right? And when he got out of the car, he set the alarm. So I'm wondering, other than like trying to steal the car, start it and steal it, is there any point to that? You can just climb right in the Jeep.
Pretty much, it's just a steal, the whole vehicle thing, probably.
Right, that's it.
What do you think?
I don't know. Yeah. I'm from Brooklyn, where you're super paranoid, and you like Scary. Remember when Scary put the club on his steering wheel outside your house in the woods?
Yeah.
Like, that's the way I am. I would put like a boot on the car. And this guy just drove up with no doors, no roof, and he alarmed it. Well, you can just climb in and take everything off the seats.
It's not a habit problem.
It is kind of funny.
Don't some of the newer Jeeps, though, have, like, the motion technology in it? So even if somebody goes and sits in it or tries to, like, stick their arm in and do stuff, it'll go off?
I don't know.
Really?
I think some of the newer Jeeps have it. I'm not 100% sure.
I got into somebody else's car at ShopRite the other day, and nothing happened.
Oh, my God. I hate that. I did
I've done that, too. How is that possible?
Wait, how did you actually get into the car?
Because there was an old person thing.
There was a car parked there that was exactly like mine, same color, everything.
Yep.
The door was open. I hit my key, I hit my unlock, and I'm like, oh, that's funny. I guess I didn't lock it. And I got in. I sat down. I'm like, wait a minute. This car is way too clean. This is not mine. And I was like, oh, my God. I got out.
You see, our minds are fried.
Mm-hmm.
We are so fried. We can't focus. The other day, I had to go to the grocery store. I had company come over, and I had to go buy, a cart filled with food. I got up to check out. It wasn't my food. It was someone else's cart.
I have stolen people's carts multiple times.
You steal, Danielle.
Not on purpose. Shut up.
It was a shitload of someone else's food. None of it I wanted. I'm like, oh, that means someone else is out there going, damn you.
I've gone to the car and I've popped the trunk and gone to load it and realized it's not my trunk that I'm loading the stuff in. Because I'm like, I don't have this in my trunk. I'm like, whose car is this? And it's the same, like you said, same color, same exact car. And I'm like, this is crazy. What the hell am I doing?
I put my kid in the wrong car last week. So I picked up my daughter from school, and the same exact car was about three spots away from where I parked. So I went in, I pulled out the car, I pulled the door open, I was putting my daughter into the car. I go, where'd your car seat go? And then my wife, Allie, was like, dummy, you're at the wrong car. Sure enough.
Have you ever been caught getting into someone else's car? They're like, hey, get out of my car.
And you want to know why? With my mom? Because the person was in the car.
Oh, my God. Shit.
Okay.
So
it happened to me in front of my own building.
Yep. My mom was she got in the passenger seat. She thought it was dad. And she started talking. And the person was like, And then she turned around. She goes, oh, my gosh, I'm so sorry. And the person started laughing, thank goodness.
Yeah,
but I would have been freaked out.
Yeah, me too.
Go ahead, Scary.
You know, I was going to say, I had an ordered an Uber, and I came downstairs, and there I was in my lobby. Black Toyota Camry pulls up.
I was with you.
I get in the back seat. Brody was there. I get in the car, and it's like some woman who, and I'm like, wait, that, and then she's like, this is my car.
There was a car seat with a baby in the back seat. He got in the car next to the baby.
Yeah.
And he's like, that's weird to have a baby in the car seat.
I used to have a Toyota Camry, early mornings when I would come into work and park on the street, we're across the street from a hotel, people would get into my car as I'm getting out, too, because I have a black Toyota Camry. Had a black Toyota Camry.
Yeah.
It would happen a handful of times. So awkward where people are like, I'm sorry, and I'm like, get out of my car.
See, I guess it's not good to have a black car or a black SUV.
I have a black car.
Yeah, or a Camry.
Yeah, I have a black car.
Or a Honda Accord.
I had the same problem that Danielle had, except on the other end of it. So I have a four-door black Dodge Charger, and I park next to a four-door black Impala, which is a full-size black car as well. And there was an older guy in the driver's seat of the car next to me. And I'm sitting there, and I was, I didn't lock the doors. I just got in from the grocery. And I'm looking at my phone before I drove away. And an older woman opens my car door and goes to get in. And I scream, what are you doing? And, you know, I guess she didn't hear well. She tried to get in my car. So she got in the car. She meant to get in the car next to me. And so the guy rolls down his window and goes, honey, you're in the wrong car. And I said, it's fine if, you know, she seems like a nice lady. He goes, you like her, you can have her.
Okay. That's like something I'd
say. Hey, has anyone on the show ever stolen a vehicle in their lifetime?
Yes, kind of.
What?
I know where you can, though.
No, so how do you kind of steal one, Scotty?
Well, before our first day of our senior year of high school, we went to a junk car lot and chained up this junk car that was sitting there and towed it to the high school parking lot and put it in the principal's parking spot. So, I mean, technically, I guess we stole a car.
You did.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's definitely stealing a car.
You weren't thrown in jail.
No, there was a bunch of us that did it.
And Froggy?
I was repoing a car. So somebody else had rented a car. And they did not take it back to the rental place. And at the time, I was kind of semi-seeing the girl that worked at the rental place. And she asked me to go with her to repo the car. So I did. I got the keys.
Wow.
I ran up to the house very, very quietly.
Were you scared?
Scared shitless. Got in this car. But I liked this girl a lot. So I was, you know, trying to be like, do it the right thing. So I got in the car. I put it in reverse. And I've never reversed so fast in my life down this long driveway and hauled ass out of there.
Did they see you?
I saw the curtains on the window in the front of the house open as I got to the end of the driveway. And I thought, this is when they start shooting. But they never did.
Okay, so have any of you ever had your car repossessed?
No.
I
used to be friends with a repo man, and of all the people I've ever known in my whole life, he is hands down the biggest asshole. He just loved dicking people over. I mean, it was his. He would like come back so excited how he snuck into a gated neighborhood and got this car, and I was just like, man.
Well, I'll tell you, back in my lean days, they said, well, we're gonna have to take your car. I just didn't have any money to pay the car payment. And so I had to hide it. I had to hide it at a friend's house.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
And they would come by. They would troll in front of my apartment. I knew they were out there looking for my car.
Yep.
And finally, I got it paid off, and we're okay. You know, they're not going to take it. But, yeah, that was scary times, man. Yep.
Yeah.
Take your car.
Those repo guys are like half PIs, too. I mean, they come up with every way to find you and get that car back.
I beat them.
You did. Good for you.
I saw a car repoed one time. I was, like, I don't know, 14, 15 years old, and I was selling newspapers in front of the post office in Erie, PA. It was my summer job. And as I'm standing there selling newspapers, I see this big truck roll in and park into a parking spot, and then this like unmarked police car come up behind it and blocked it in.
Oh.
So then I'm like, okay, I wonder what's happening here. And the guy whose truck it was comes out of the post office and walks up, and then this guy gets out of the unmarked cop car. And then they start, like, arguing back and forth. The guy is trying to get into his truck. And then the cop takes out a knife and slashes the back tire.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
And then the guy gets in his face. I thought somebody was going to get shot. I mean, like ducking behind a mailbox.
Oh, my God.
And then, like, 2 minutes later, a tow truck comes down. And, you know, hooks up the truck that this guy's truck and then hauls it away. And this guy comes over to me and says, you saw everything, right? That guy was an asshole. Well, I'm going to sue his ass. I'm like, I'm just 14 selling newspapers. Yeah, don't talk to me.
You don't want to have a part of that.
Yeah.
My friend owns a tow truck company on Staten Island. He says, if you ever want to see a grown man cry, tow his car. Like, because every time they are towing cars, because either they're parked in a parking lot they're not supposed to, or a meter, every grown man ends up crying to them, and with the same excuse of, but I was just, it was just a second. It was a second, please. And my life is in every man's life on Staten Island is in shambles.
Well, I know, but you take away your car. I mean, it really kind of fucks you up a little bit.
It really does. I mean, you can't go to work. There's, nope. And what we've talked about this a little bit, it costs so much money to be poor. It's insane. So you're having a hard time paying your car note. And then on top of that, now you're going to pay an impound fee, and you have to pay for the tow. and sometimes they damage your car, and then you don't get to work. Like, it's just this pileup on top of all the other crap. Yep. Screw your friend, Garrett.
But when the sign clearly says, do not park in the deli, only for deli customers, and you go right next door to the bank,
correct,
you deserve to get towed.
Exactly.
You deserve a ticket. You deserve maybe like a $60 ticket, not well, all of
says,
that other stuff.
What if it
stuff
says on the sign you're going to be towed? We will tow yep offenders. I mean,
then
it's too, right there.
Too
it tells
bad
you.
Yeah, you take
they're
your chance.
They're all too bad.
But the other thing I noticed too, you ever want to steal a car, because Elvis, you asked if you ever stolen a car.
Right.
In my town, all the cars get stolen from 7-Eleven because people decide to leave their car keys inside the car.
They
what
keep,
dumb,
they keep the car running. Running.
But why? Yeah. Who
I
does
don't know
that?
Like, how much effort does it take to turn off your car? But
right,
I see this all the time. People who leave their car running, they run into the convenience store.
And their
store
kid in the back seat too.
Oh, yeah, that's
the
worst.
That's an invitation to take your shit.
No.
Well, on top of that, too, like when you park your car at your house, the other thing people steal cars with, they leave the keys in the car. Like,
mm-hmm,
I've never left my, I, you know, you do on occasion, but not every time.
Never.
You're just asking for your car to
so
be stolen.
My friend had his car stolen right out of his garage. He had the keys. He had to push to start, so he left the keys on the dashboard where he always leaves them, and he left his garage door open. So somebody just walked in, started the car with the push button, and drove the car off.
My favorite stories is there's someone says someone broke into my car last night and stole all my cash. Well, how much cash? Like around $2,500.
Well, what the hell
why
is it
doing
your
in your car?
Why the fuck are you putting $2,500 in cash
oh
in your car?
Gosh.
What do they do for a living if they have $2,500?
Well, I don't
awesome
know. Well, I just why would you have it in your car? Like, what are you doing? And so I don't want to say out loud, well, you asked for that, but I kind of wanted to.
Yeah, my right neighborhood where I
you
lived
just,
in...
You just victim-shamed.
In South Florida, the lady had her car stolen. And so the next day, she was like going around, hey, somebody broke in my car last night and stole it. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, how'd that happen? Well, I left my purse and the keys and everything right on the center console. Okay, well then they didn't fucking
hello
break in then.
Oh,
the
lady
shit was right
God
there for them to take it. Like, that's not breaking in. It's right there. I mean, you just got in the car,
it's
pushed
still
the start.
Breaking in.
No, you didn't break. Technically,
if
you didn't.
Well, leave your front door open and someone walks in and robs you, they're still breaking into your house.
You didn't break anything to get in.
Okay. But it's a break-in.
It's
hello
still a break-in.
Yeah. Yeah. Plus, a lot of cars
open
now, when you leave the keys in them and close the door, it goes beep, beep, beep.
Right.
So when you hear that, you know that, and but
right
people still walk away from
right
it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's how cars get stolen.
Well, wait, you know what happened to me at one of the parking garages? I pulled my car in, parked the car, come back to get the car. They're like, it took them like half an hour. They couldn't figure it out. They finally realized that they had my automatic starter. They dropped it in someone else's car.
Yep.
And that person already left.
I had that happen to me at a valet one time.
Yeah.
Oh,
so they're
awful.
Like, we can't give you your car. You're going to have to call the dealership. So I had to call the dealership,
oh,
get them to make a new key fob.
Which is like
wait 24 hours.
Yeah.
Right. They had to pay for it. Wait for the mm-hmm next day to go pick it up, come back into the city. It was such a mess. I was so, and what do they give me for my trouble?
Nothing.
Nothing.
None.
Oh, you don't have to pay for his parking here today. Oh, thank you. That's fantastic.
Right.
Thanks so much.
Assholes. Like, all right. Well, we've all agreed. We all agree that having a car is a pain in the ass. Let's get rid of them and just have
no
drivers.
Yes. That's what I do.
I love mine.
Car.
Are we done?
Yep, we're done.
Yep.
All right. Hope you have a great day, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.